He put the bell of his horn right into the microphone and changed the whole world of jazz right there.
He comes up with a style that is truly reflective of
right. There's nothing cooler than the other side of the pillow. Right. I beg to differ. Miles Davis, one of the coolest human beings to ever walk this earth. Of course, the jazz great, the musical icon. Now there is a documentary called Miles Davis, The Birth of Cool. We welcome three guests this morning who know Mr. Davis very well. Say good morning to Vince Wilburn, nephew on the left. This is Aaron Davis, the son of Miles Davis in the middle, and Stanley Nelson. You directed The Birth of Cool, and you call it The Cool, right? Why is it The Birth of The Cool?
Well, that's the name of one of Miles' albums.
Yeah.
It was The Birth of the Cool, so we took that. We thought that was a perfect name for the film. It kind of epitomized Miles, so that's the name of the film.
And talk about it, Aaron. We've seen your dad's life chronicled in so many things, and of course his music will live on forever. Does this touch base on things that we've never seen before?
Oh yeah, I mean it touches as much as of his life as we can get. It's a very all-encompassing piece. It shows him good side, bad side, however you want to describe it. But it really touches on what kind of person he was and how his career and his love of music and the arts defined him.
Such a cerebral man, born in Alton, lived in East St. Louis. The family lived in East St. Louis. Vince, talk about what you learned most from your Uncle Miles.
To trust in your instincts, never look back.
Do you play?
Yes, I play drums.
Yeah, you do?
We both worked with Uncle Miles.
Yeah, you both worked with Uncle Miles.
Toured with him, worked on his record.
That's awesome. And you find that students of music today are still looking at his craft and trying to still be like Miles.
Oh yeah, you gotta unlock the code, but there's no key.
I love that. And was that the premise of the film, that you wanted to kind of unlock more of what we already knew about him?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, the basis of Miles is always the music, you know, but there's so much that we don't know. And the film is kind of warts and all, and I think that's what makes the film really interesting, because Miles is such a complicated character. But we also had, you know, the permission to use any music that we wanted to use, and so we did.
That's hard to do in this day and age with licensing and stuff, right?
Yeah, it costs a lot of money.
Yes, it does. And there's also dialogue and interviews and photographs that we've never seen before either.
Yeah, we found footage, home movies of Miles that somebody had in their basement that we used throughout the film. You know, we interview, you know, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, Carlos Santana, Jimmy Cobb, all those people are in the film. Quincy Jones is in the film. So it's a really interesting and I think really funny film too. Yeah.
It is a funny film.
Yeah.
Really, okay, when I think of Miles Davis, I don't think funny. I think just flat out cool, right? What's funny about your dad? Little nugget.
Well, he had a really great sense of humor, and he, you know, he came from this part of the world, the St. Louis, East St. Louis, so we get some of that Midwest humor.
And all you saw was him with his beautiful high cheekbones and his eyes closed and swaying to the music.
One of the things that happened for me in talking to people as we were researching is everybody who knew Miles talked about how funny he was. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to make sure that we got that side of him in the film, and I think we do, and there are just a lot of funny people in the film.
That is awesome. If you are a fan of music, a fan of Miles Davis, a student of the music, a student of cool, this is the film for you to watch. It's called Miles Davis, Birth of the Cool. Starting today, it's going to be showing at Landmark Tivoli Theater, and you can get tickets. I think there's a few showings, and you guys are going to have a Q&A later on tonight, right?
Right. Today, tomorrow, and Sunday, we do a Q&A.
I think you're going to get a lot of music students there.
Yeah. And if you go to milesdavismovie.com, that's probably the easiest way to find out how to get tickets. It also talks about where the film plays around the country, because it's opening week by week.
Awesome. Do you hope it goes to other festivals and maybe gets even more attention?
Well, it's going to theaters now.
Yeah.
So we opened it at the Sundance Festival in January, so we had a great opening there.
Oh, that's awesome.
And we've been selling out in New York and LA for the last 2 weeks, and this is our second
Oscar,
week.
Oscar. You heard it here. You heard it here.
Vote for
us. Starts today.
MilesDavisMovie.com. We will connect you on our website as well as our Fox 2 mobile app and all of our social media sites. Thank you all for coming.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
It.
Thanks so much.
And thank heavens for Miles Davis. Holy cow. We will be back.